this part of the series on reactive maps on Android, I'll be walking you through a library that enables you to integrate our SDKs with a very popular library on Android, RxJava. RxJava is the Java implementation of Reactive Extensions, which is a library for composing asynchronous and event-based programs using observable sequences. That's quite a mouthful, so let's dig into that a little bit. In the first video in the series, I showed you a code snippet from an app I'm working on called Old Places. Snippet implements a network call to fetch new places after a half-second delay when a user moves to a new location on the map. You've seen how this implementation, while correct, can be error-prone due to having a lot of nested callbacks. Apart from that, you'll also need to handle errors in case one of the async calls fails, and you'll also need to ensure you're not leaking memory by canceling asynchronous requests when they're no longer needed. You get the picture. Accounting for these considerations when you have a lot of asynchronous behavior to coordinate, it's easy to mess up. This is where RxJava comes in handy. It allows you to convert callback-based asynchronous code into a chain of transformations. In the Rx world, there are three core constructs. The first construct is an observable, which is at the core of RxJava. It represents a stream of events emitted over time. Anything can be modeled as a stream of events, like camera move events on a map. Next are operators, which modify or transform events emitted from an observable. For example, the delay operator applies a set amount of time before passing items downstream. And lastly, observers are objects that get notified when there is an event coming downstream. Going back to our original callback-based code snippet, we can rewrite our code by using observables. Instead of calling setOnCameraIdleListener, we can use the extension function provided by the MapsRx library called CameraIdleEvents, which is an observable that emits events whenever the camera goes idle. Next, to implement a half-second delay, we can call the delay function on the CameraIdleEvents observable, which will delay emissions downstream by 500 milliseconds. The network call can also be modeled with observables, which we can chain after the delay operator using the flatMap operator. FlatMap is an operator that takes in an item and returns another observable as a result. Here I'm assuming that our network client class can return an observable rather than having to provide a callback to the request. Lastly, to receive events from the stream, we can call subscribe and provide it a lambda. Here I'm printing to the console that we have received new places. To handle errors, we can pass another lambda to the onError parameter of the observer. The lambda will get invoked whenever there is a failure somewhere within our stream. And to cancel requests, we can keep a reference to the disposable object return on subscription so that we can later dispose of it when needed, such as when the containing activity enters the background. After completing this step, when the map camera moves and goes idle, after a few moments, you can see the observer receiving the event and logging the statement "got new places" should be printed on the console. To start using this library, add the MapsRx library to your build.gradle file. And if you're using the Places SDK, you can also include the PlacesRx library in your build.gradle file to use observables with the Places SDK. While I've covered camera idle events, the MapsRx library contains more extension functions around events that return observables, such as marker and map click events. I've linked the GitHub repository in the description of this video, so feel free to check it out. Thanks for following along so far. Hopefully you can now get started using RxJava observables in your app using the MapsRx library. If you have a question, leave a comment below and make sure to subscribe to our channel. As always, happy mapping.
Just in case, classic Chris.